Stay informed. COVID-19 testing. When should I be tested for COVID-19?
There are some scenarios that you are going to want to consider getting a COVID-19 test. One of them is the obvious. So you're not feeling well. You have symptoms that are consistent with COVID-19. In that scenario, you may have a home test that you may want to consider, or perhaps going to a lab for a PCR-based test. If you do have a home test and you do have symptoms and that home test is negative, that's going to be the scenario that we do recommend coming in to a lab setting and getting a PCR-based test. Testing is also something that is now a consideration if you'd like to come out of quarantine. So for example, you've been exposed to someone with COVID-19. You do not have any symptoms. You are not vaccinated, and it's recommended that you stay home for the 5 days. On day 6, you can consider a test, and that can be a antigen-based test that you can get from a local pharmacy or a home test, or a lab-based PCR test.
When shouldn't I be tested for COVID-19?
One setting that you are not going to want to continue getting a lab-based test or a PCR test is if you've had COVID-19 in the last 90 days and you are recommended to have a screening test, for example. We do not recommend repeating that labbed PCR-based test. We know that those tests can continue to pick up nucleic acid or fragments of the genetic fragments of that virus, and it may inadvertently give you a false positive. So we do not recommend a repeat PCR within 90 days of a positive test.
How do I know if I should take an at-home test or seek out a PCR test?
A common, I think, scenario that you can consider rapid testing or home testing is if you're not feeling well and you do have symptoms consistent with COVID-19. And you do receive a positive test, that would be considered a valid result. On the flip side, if you are having symptoms and that rapid home test is negative, that's going to be the scenario of when you're going to want to go and consider that lab-based test. We know that home or rapid type of testing does have its limitations and that you may have some false negatives.
Will positivity rates decrease with at-home testing?
When we look at case counts from the community, we get that information from positive tests that are obtained in a lab setting. So we do realize now with the availability of home-based tests that those results do not get picked up and counted in our community case counts. So there can be, you know, perhaps a skewing of the numbers, or perhaps an underrepresentation of those positive cases in the community.